Hey, Switchheads, I hope you're all doing well. Kanan here, and welcome to my review of 8 Bodies DX, which will be released on the 31st of March 2021 and will be coming to you on the Nintendo Switch, the Xbox, and the PS4, as well as Steam and GOG. I've dropped a link to the Nintendo Switch EU and US down below. Feel free to check them out. But will this puzzler, platformer, Metroidvania-like game make it onto the Wall of Fame, or will it be relegated down to the bottom of the sea in the Wall of Shame? Or maybe somewhere in the middle? And don't forget, as always, click that link below. It will take you to our community Discord where we can all join in a good conversation or maybe do some streaming together. And also, if you've enjoyed any of my content, you know what to do. Gameplay. Oh boy, this was one that really was difficult to get into. Not because I didn't like the game, but more the fact that there was so much to actually get into, so much to actually grasp, and so much to actually do within the game. Essentially, you have crashed your vehicle in the sea, and you are then ending up exploring this lost city, as I can gather, with these other creatures and obviously some bad and some good guys. Their story is okay. I'm not going to pretend I knew or understood everything to do with it, but there are some good narrative bits within this game, and I did listen to the most part. Whilst you're actually playing, you'll be swimming underwater, diving, and all sorts, and then you'll be like in caves and things like that, exploring your little hearts out and kind of like defending yourselves against these monsters and finding out about these creatures that you find a bit later on in the game and kind of like helping them out as well. The actual mechanics of the game is, well, there's a lot of them to be honest with you. So out of order, you basically control your character left and right. You can dive into water, swim underwater, as I've said. You eventually get a gun which you can fire around in different directions. You can also get better and more weapons, and you could also get better and different gear. There is a full map within this game, and it's kind of mind-boggling. You can see all the different exits and entrances and where you can actually go. That does actually help, and it kind of makes a lot of sense when you actually look at it. And I kind of like really like the way this is done. So if this is normal in these sort of games, then I think I've been kind of like missing out on something good here. So as well as your weapon, you get kind of like this buddy droid type thing that if someone wants to come in and play multiplayer with you, they kind of can using that character. I didn't have anyone to play with on multiplayer, but from what I could gather, it's kind of like they're along sort of for the journey, but they do actually help quite a bit. As well as your gun, you also get like bombs that you can blow away parts of like loose materials within caves. There's also a dash button and a kind of roll button that you can roll past creatures and the like. There are bosses here, and as well as like being a bit confusing to start with, I think that's actually quite neat because I had to think my way how to actually defeat them. But once you know how to defeat them, then they get kind of like easy, which I suppose is the whole point. You get these different tunnels as well that you can go through, all different color coded, and you have to use different means to get through them, such as like some of them that you can just shoot, and some of them you need like upgrades and all to do, just like the purple ones where you have to upgrade your gun so you do like a mega blast by holding down the trigger button for a little bit. And then there are teleporters as well that you can go through, and they get you to different areas. And then, as well as the creatures, you also get the obligatory like obstacles or traps like spikes and the like. The creatures are all kind of, yeah, they're pretty okay. There's lots of different ones, and I really did like the shark character. He was kind of funny in a weird kind of way. And then there's the Wozan, which entwines itself into the story, and I'm not going to really spoil that, but you do end up doing things with them and helping them to do other things, which kind of surprised me because I didn't think that you would be going down in that direction, but you did, and it was a good surprise, and I think I'll leave it to you to discover that yourselves. Okay, I can understand this sounding a bit of a muddle of a review, but there is so much here. I'm finding it kind of difficult to actually say everything, and I really do apologize if I missed anything out. All you need to know realistically is it's a Metroidvania style game. It has puzzling elements, a quite decentish nice story, a good amount of monsters, and it's fun to play. Graphically, it's definitely pixel art, and it's definitely looking old school pixel art, and I think that's the point, isn't it? The different creatures, the different animations on like the teleporter and everything, they all look pretty cool, and I quite enjoyed it visually. The audio is kind of what you expect. There's nice little sounds for all the different things you do, a nice little crunchy sound when you're running around, and it sounds pretty cool. It was all pretty standard in that regard. As for the actual soundtrack, it was quite nice, calming at most, and you know, I quite enjoyed it. It was already defaulted turned down, so I just left it where it was and just enjoyed it as I went along. The good. I quite like the actual animations of the Wozen, especially when you're running past them, it's quite funny. I have found it hard to put this game down. I haven't completed it yet, but I am, you know, a good few hours into it, and I think this is going to probably last a good, like, 4 hours or so, probably five maybe for myself, because I'm slower at these sort of games, as I'm not entirely used to them. The bad. The controls can sometimes be a little bit finicky if I had to be picky, and I found myself dying now and again because of that reason. The score. So I'm going to give this straight away a 4 out of 5. I have enjoyed this. I'm enjoying playing it even more. I think the sheer fact that it lets you upgrade and get better equipment as you go along is definitely a good thing with this game, and I think that's why it's dragging me to want to complete it fully. And as for my alternative, well, that's going to be Sundered Eldritch Edition. I have played this. It's a type of Metroidvania game, and it's also multiplayer, and it also has puzzling type of mechanics. And it's a very good game, and I find it fun and very enjoyable. And would definitely recommend you picking it up after you've completed Out Buddies. And so, what do you think? Leave it all down in the comments. That's where it all belongs. Or come and join us in our Discord channel and, you know, come for a chat or come for the streaming, whichever you want. And don't forget, if you enjoy my content, you know what to do, because life is better when we switch together.